Dr. Mark Vaughn of the Auburn Medical Group, thanks for joining us. We are going to freeze off an actinic keratosis in the brow of Eric on the left side. Enjoy. So we got your arm all taken care of, got a little bandage on it there, and now we have these actinic keratosis lesions. So lots of keratin being produced. Oftentimes they'll have a pink base to them. I feel that one. Do you feel any others, Eric?
No, it was really just localized to that area.
Okay. Oftentimes we'll get them on the on this area here on the cheek, on the temples, on the tips of the ears. Although you have hair on yours, you're okay. And a very easy treatment for it is to just spray liquid nitrogen. You can see that it comes out just, that's a liquid as it comes out, and it turns to a gas right away and just becomes nitrogen that is in the air that we're breathing. It's what? 70%+ nitrogen, something like that. Are you an engineer?
Yes, about 78, right?
Okay, 78, that sounds right. 21% oxygen, 70% nitrogen, and a little bit of...
all the other good stuff.
Yeah, you probably know it better than I do. So let me get this really close. I like to get very close with this. Oh, you can see powder on my fingers from the gloves. Very, very close, and we're just going to get it and barely a little color around it, just a millimeter, and then let it stay white for a while. 10 to 20 seconds, it thaws out, and then once it's thawed, it's time to do it again. So two freeze-thaw cycles are what's recommended to kill these things. And then you'll have a little blister there, you'll have frostbite. Tomorrow morning, you'll see it. So now it's time to have, it's still white, but it's gonna thaw out. And we recommend just putting a little bit of Aquaphor, we'll give you some, just to keep it moist until it's scabbed over, like your arm already is. So let's look at liquid nitrogen. It's a colorless liquid. I don't know if you can really see in there. Have you ever looked in? Have you seen it?
Yeah, we played with it in physics class,
yes. Let's just take a little piece of gauze and see what happens if we stick it in the liquid nitrogen. I thought it would make it all hard, but it doesn't. I guess you have to have something with some water content to it for it to make it like a rose, which somebody did get roses today. I don't know who it is. I saw a bouquet of roses. Did you bring that for somebody?
No.
I'm getting
in trouble. Sorry, not this time.
It wasn't for me?
I'm not putting that on the record.
So we can pour it out on the floor and you can kind of see how it pretty much turns to a vapor right away.
Yeah, make like a little blob and try to put
it on. All right, let's do that. That'd be fun. All right. All right, we're making soft soap into hard soap. Ow! You got me. There's a little drop that was going across over there. Yeah, we made hard soap. Let's see. Oh no, it's still soft in the middle. It's not enough water content to totally freeze up. Let's have some fun with some water. So if we run water down the sink, we pour this in with it. That's pretty cool. Oh, you can hear it bubbling. Well, that was fun. Well, Eric, thanks for exploring the world of liquid nitrogen with us today.
My pleasure, that was fun.
So these will heal up pretty nicely. We'll keep an eye on you. We want to check you probably sometime around summer to see how your skin's doing, because you do have a tendency to get these things, and we'll let you know on the results. And are you okay with us writing in the description of the video what the results of the biopsy
sure.
are? So we can let you guys know too. So we'll go ahead and close, let you guys know that you can always subscribe and share our videos. Until next time, this is Eric and Dr. Vaughn telling all of you to stay in good health.